Hello, friends and family of Forever Comics. Here we are, week one of the New 52 from DC Comics. I'm going to share with you briefly just the books I picked up this week. First of all, we got the Green Arrow. I'm not too happy about the new redesign, but overall, I look forward to the story. The artwork's not too bad on its own, and they seem to be adding a whole new repertoire of weapons and technology to his book, so I look forward to see what they got going on. Batgirl. Barbara Gordon finally returns to the mantle of Batgirl with the awesome writing of Gail Simone and artwork from Adrian Saif. I really look forward to the story. I haven't had a chance to read it yet, but once I'm done, I'll give a full review on the page. Number 3, from Marvel Comics, the New Avengers Annual Number 1. This book gives us a breakdown of what the Avengers have been on going through for the past few years, and also gives us a sneak peek at the forthcoming books called The New Dark Avengers, which turns our team of Avengers into a group of villains. So I really look forward to that storyline to see how that'll evolve. Book number 4, and probably the best story that I've read with the New 52 so far, Detective Comics number 1. This story shows the Joker setting up a plan, some diabolical plan. We don't know what's going to go on yet, but we see him go through a transformation that'll maybe make Batman shake in his boots a little bit. Definitely shook him out of his shorts. So now we'll see what the Joker's going to go with, and we'll see what the Dark Knight has got in store for Gotham City. And now to the biggest book and probably the most sought-after variant comic that you're going to be people looking for in the next coming weeks and maybe the next coming years. Action Comics number 1 starts off with a story about Superman like you've never seen before. This basically takes place after Superman leaves Smallville and comes to the big city, Metropolis. Get ready to see Superman in what looks to be a rundown country boy suit. And this is just him making a fresh start. And everybody being really confused. Some people are with him, a lot of people against him. The authorities really don't know what to make of him yet. And luckily, thanks to my friends over at Comic Book Jones, my local comic shop, I was able to attain a variant cover. Very rare to get a variant cover, very hard to get one. If we're lucky to get one, you know, collectors like us, you know, we just really appreciate this stuff, and we'll do almost anything to get them. Luckily enough, I didn't have to, you know, spend an arm and a leg to get it, and hopefully everybody gets a chance to check these out too. So until then, I'll see you all in the pages.